Hey everyone, so I'm in a little bit of a different setup. I usually film right in front of my window over here in my living room, but for some reason there's really not a lot of light coming through there. So I'm in front of my screen door. You're probably going to hear my neighbors walking around and chatting. This is my dog, Kit. I don't know how long she's going to be here, but for the moment she's going to chill here. So today's video is going to be my favorite under eye concealers. I've mentioned before on my channel that under eye concealers are really the reason I started to get involved in makeup. I feel like most young girls don't really deal with really, really dry, dark circles. But I always have. It's just genetic, it runs in my family. So I would try and use concealers that my friends were using or that I could just run and pick up at the drugstore, and it just looked crepey, it looked heavy, it just looks very scaly. I take the approach where I would rather have a tiny bit less coverage and it look more natural, healthier, and just look a little bit fresher under the eyes rather than having really heavy coverage and it looking very apparent that you have a lot of concealer under the eyes. Because I think even though that looks great in a picture or even a video, it looks really heavy and very, very makeup-y in person. It draws more attention to what I'm trying to hide. So essentially, concealers are probably my favorite products to try, either concealers or foundation. It's really hard to make one that I will like. I'm extremely picky, and these three concealers are by far my favorite. I could not even count how many concealers I've used for under the eyes. So I'm gonna start with my third favorite and go to my top favorite. Number three is the Tarte Colored Clay CC Under Eye Correctors. It's essentially a concealer and I use it as a concealer for under the eyes. I don't need to put anything on top of it. It's not incredibly, incredibly orange. This is in the shade Light Medium. It's very peachy, so it cancels out any of the darkness under your eyes, but it's not so peachy and so pigmented and thick that you need a concealer to put on top of it. It actually cancels out in such a way that I don't feel the need to do that. So it gives about a medium coverage, and it is also very dewy. It's probably the thickest product out of the three, but it is by no means really heavy. It's actually quite emollient, which makes it great because if you have very dry skin under the eyes, it's gonna hydrate it and it's not going to look really heavy. If you like completely creaseless concealer, I would definitely set this down. But what's good about it is that when you blend it out, the coverage remains the same, which is something I really enjoy about it. It's great for natural days, and it's really great when I have very, very deep dark under eye circles, but I can also wear this with a full coverage foundation and I don't feel like I'm missing coverage there. This is great because it really covers the dark circles, but it is also quite hydrating. I feel like this product is kind of a combination of the two other products I'm about to talk about. The second product, my second favorite concealer for under the eyes, is a product that I mentioned in my last video comparing the Kojendo Aqua Foundation and the Kojendo Moisture Foundation. And it is the Kojendo Moisture Fit Concealer. You know, I just had a hunch when I saw this on the Kojendo website that I was going to like it. Again, concealers for me are really like hit or miss. There are some that I can appreciate and I don't think are bad. In order for me to really love a concealer, it takes a lot. This concealer is really great because it gives a good medium coverage and it sets quite quickly. So once you blend it in, it sets. It's almost like almost a matte finish, so you don't need to powder it. It's very, very crease resistant as well. I think this one would work no matter what for any skin type. So even if you don't have very, very dry skin, I would recommend this. Now, if you have really flaking under eyes, I would go with one of the other concealers because I find that this is the least hydrating. It's not by any means drying, but I really like this one because I don't feel the need to put a powder on top of it. And it almost gives the effect that it has like flattened any of the hollowness under my eyes. I've only been using it for a few weeks now, and I am thoroughly, thoroughly impressed with it. The texture, again, it's definitely the least dewy out of the three concealers. It goes on creamy, and then it sets right down. I feel like this is what I wanted the NARS Radiant Creamy Concealer to be like. It is just slightly thinner than that. It is still a very creamy texture, but it sets right down and gives very significant coverage like the NARS Radiant Creamy Concealer. Doesn't budge, wears all day. It's an expensive product, but I'm definitely going to be repurchasing it. So the reason that this concealer is still my first and foremost favorite concealer for dry, dark under eyes is that it has the best shade range and it is the most affordable, but it's also my most tried and true product. The other two concealers that I've talked about, I'm pretty sure only have two shades per concealer. So, but my top favorite concealer is the Maybelline Fit Me Concealer. It is a liquid concealer, but it is still super, super creamy and easy to blend out onto the skin. It is the perfect liquid concealer that is just creamy enough. It's very, very dewy, which makes it very hydrating. If you have very, very dry under eyes, I urge you, please just don't go with the most full coverage concealer and say, well, I just have to deal with it. I understand that a lot of you really hate creasing under the eyes, but there are ways around that, and I've found ways around that. I think going with a really dewy and hydrating concealer is really the way to go to make everything look as natural while still offering coverage. So what I do with the Maybelline Fit Me Concealer, and this is always how I apply this concealer. I really don't like applying it any other way. I apply as much as I need under the eyes and I let it sit for probably a minute or two. This actually lets the concealer set down a little bit because it is so dewy and hydrating. It will sheer out very easily, but when it sets down, the coverage stays in one place. Still is not quite set down yet, so it'll just blend all the edges out, but the coverage where you need it will still be concentrated in the area that you need it, which for me is like this little hollow. I love the concealer because it's very affordable. It will never make your under eyes look dry, like never. It's also great to mix in with like a more full coverage concealer if you want. For me, it always looks great. So yeah, I hope this video was helpful for you guys. I've hit 1,000 subscribers, which is really awesome. I've been doing this for about a year now, or coming up on a year. I just feel great that I kind of hit that milestone. I mentioned in a couple of videos ago that I'm gonna have a giveaway that is still happening. I'm just waiting for the giveaway prize to arrive in the mail. So expect next week's video to feature the giveaway and the prize. As always, if you guys have any other questions about the products themselves, I would be happy to answer. And I will see you in my next video. Stop, kid. Stop. Stop it. Oh my god, you scared the fuck out of me.